big goop move like the ocean. Hey. Human beings, what is up? It is Freak from the Beauty and the Freak Reaction Channel. And basically all I'm doing today is basically what I'm doing today is just kind of going over the whole Drake versus Kendrick Lamar diss, why I like each one, and which one I think is the strongest one after a good day of listening. All right, if you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. All right, and comment down below. Yeah. So, all right, let's get into it. As for Kendrick's diss, yeah, it's definitely top tier. All right, I don't really look at the bias in either way. I know some people want to trash Drake's, some people want to trash Kendrick's. Usually those are biased fans on the other side, but I'm gonna keep it 100, man. Like, I don't do the bias stuff, even if I really like an artist. And honestly, I do like Kendrick Lamar overall as an artist and lyrically as a lyrical rapper more than I like Drake, but I'm trying to keep it less biased as possible. Okay, anyway, Kendrick Lamar's diss, I mean, it was just basically everything you need in a beef, in a diss track, right? He had flow, he had crazy cadence, rhyme schemes were crazy, right? The things he was saying, the lyrics in themselves, he had doubles, double entendres, really good metaphor every now and then. Like, bro, the whole thing was the whole package. You know, he changed the tone of his voice, you know, such as other rappers like, you know, Eminem, Tech N9ne, you know, really lyrical rappers know how to change their voice when they're doing certain parts of a bar, if needed, you know. But I'm all in on this. I love this type of, it's really good for hip hop. I love this type of energy. And I'm also a rapper myself, a singer. I'm an artist. You guys can definitely check out my music in the links down below. Okay, I have another music channel I do as well. Yeah, as for Drake, I know that was a shameless plug, by the way. As for Drake's, though, I feel like his was, you know, obviously it wasn't, we still need a full diss track targeted at Kendrick alone, because he was also busy, getting busy dissing other people as well, which is why I really respect the diss as of a whole. And as for TaylorMade was actually really, really fire as well. When it comes to using AI and actually trying to use it with in a positive way. And I think he created something new there in a sense, you know. Obviously, it was just a, hey, I'm trying to get it out. Come on, Kendrick, where you at? type of diss track. But yeah, both of those equally, I think, were on the same level as Kendrick's current, you know, Euphoria diss, because Euphoria was 6 minutes of just straight screw you Drake type of thing. And Drake's, like I said, the first one, 50 push-ups, drop and give me 50 or whatever it's called, I can't remember, but that was like hitting at everybody, but he was definitely hitting at Kendrick in a lot of it as well, which is, you know, why it's considered the first round, you know. But currently, I think that Kendrick's got the one up here, and it's not by a bunch, in my opinion. I thought it was going to be by a whole blowout, but, like, Drake really did his thing, you know? So, I don't want to say anybody's, like, totally bodied anybody yet. So, that's why we still rating for round two. Round two. Let's get it. Where you at, Drake? So, I'm excited. You know, Kendrick, I'm rooting for you, too, but it... You just never know with these types of caliber of beefs, you know what I'm saying? They're both very lyrical. If Drake is writing, I really want to believe Drake is writing, because I know that people give him the flack for the ghostwriting and all that. And it's true. You know, if you've already been documented with ghostwriters, then we can't help but think that, you know, Kendrick's not known for shit like that. So I'm wanting to believe that Drake really is writing, because, I mean, he is a phenomenal writer. He has written really technical raps, most of his stuff, I do believe. and he's written singing songs for other artists. So I know he writes, and I would like to think that he would not pull no Benzino ghostwriting shit. You know what I'm saying? That would just be corny, and you would just be not validated if it ever comes out. So, yeah. Let's get it. Maybe J. Cole will surprise us with something, trying to get back into this war, even though it's kind of dead at the moment, but it would be interesting to see. All right. Like I said, if you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. All right. And comment down below. Yeah. All right, I'm back. Remember, I wish that I could talk. Remember, check out the music. Add a song to your playlist. Check out the merch. Stay Up merch. It's a song I have, and I have a line of clothing for it as well. All right, there's a bunch of other stuff on there. Please support the channel. I'm out. Y'all be positive. Stay up.
Had a big head, now you got a little head. Had a big head, now you got a little head. Had a big head, now you got a little head.
I'm vibing on the island, feeling like a pilot. Now you looking at my necklace. Shades on, cause the shit too blinding. I'm shining. And I'm so confident. They call it cocky, but I call it confidence. Nobody in competition is fucking.